Greetings, fellow Earthlings. Welcome back to 34. Today's mission at hand is Chain Lightning. After liberating an enemy camp, painstakingly in Birds of Prey, I seriously hope that this mission is not that difficult, but then again, I suppose that is just the feature of the map here. So, penetrate enemy lines and laser designate SAM and artillery sites from the naval bombardment. I will try to make proper use of the laser designated this time around, unlike Operation. Which operation was it again? The convoy operation in the Uzbekistan campaign where we had laser designated for the first time. Anyway, let's see what this mission is about without wasting further time. That is a fancy looking map. That's a very fancy looking map. The infiltration is very far from the objective, and it seems that we have got two objectives here again. Yeah, so one would be SAM site and the other would probably be an artillery site. Your insertion point is approximately 655 meters from a hill that overlooks both objective Orion and objective Night. Proceed cautiously eastward along your axis of advance, taking care to avoid contact with enemy patrols. Once you reach the hill, place the artillery and SAMs south of you at objective Orion, and the SAMs north of you at objective Night. Okay. And call for artillery strikes. So basically, I'm supposed to, at checkpoint 3 here, I'm supposed to checkpoint Charlie, I suppose. Or rather checkpoint Bravo, because this is the insertion point, checkpoint Alpha, Bravo, Charlie, Delta. And this is probably Echo, or rather exfil point. Anyway, taking care to avoid contact with enemy patrols. Once you reach the hill, release the artillery and SAMs south of you at objective Orion and SAMs north of you at objective Night, and call for artillery strikes. So basically, we should avoid contact until and unless the artillery sets in, and only then are we supposed to break out the guns. Okay, got it. Once the targets are destroyed, proceed to the extraction point. In order for this mission to be successful, the 6 targets at Orion and the 3 targets at Night must be destroyed, and we must reach your extraction site. I certainly hope that we should be able to do it properly, without, you know, many problems. Now, while they do say that, what I notice here is that the extraction point is not marked as number 6. So I'm guessing that as soon as we destroy the sites, successfully destroy them, we should be able to extract. Like the mission should be over, is what I think. Also, the fact that we will probably be unable to sneak past these patrols anyway. So I'll still try with the M4, but let's see if things get difficult, I'll switch over to the sniper as well. Expected enemy forces. Acoustical surveillance of the area indicates that it is highly patrolled. In addition to the two objectives, satellite imagery shows an enemy helicopter base west of Orion and a support base north of Night. Expect a swift response if you are detected. Roger. Allied support. Alpha team will insert approximately 255 meters south of the helicopter base. Charlie team will insert approximately 255 meters from the support base. Both will launch diversionary attacks in their areas and die in the process. In addition, Whiskey Company is on standby. Whiskey Company, IS, the mortar crew. You're authorized 6 artillery fire missions. My god. Damn, that is a lot. Situation: the extensive SAM concentrations protecting the enemy front lines is resulting in unacceptable fixed wing losses. When they say fixed wing losses, I suppose they mean aeroplanes. You know, not things with wings that rotate, I suppose. Satellite reconnaissance has located the enemy's main SAM concentration. The high SAM threat coupled with aggressive combat air patrols over the target package make taking the site out with bombers impractical. Joint Operations Command has been tasked with increasing the target area and lasing the SAM and LRSV units located there for artillery bombardment. Now, I wonder what LRSV was. I forgot. I'll check it out during commentary, like while editing, and I'll probably paste the definition here if I haven't done that already. 50 caliber. Now, they are recommending that I take the 50 caliber, and I suppose the 50 caliber is better for this map, because even from the map itself, you can tell that everybody's completely spaced out. So I suppose that is not a bad choice at all. Let's start this mission.
Bravo, your objectives are the LRSVs and the SA-2s.
Attempt number 5, and yeah, this mission isn't...
Bravo, you are compromised. Proceed with mission. I repeat, proceed with mission.
This mission isn't particularly difficult, it just has like this thing where stealth is impossible, so you should probably just play it like you normally should. Like, basically just take everyone out in your way. And the cool part about this mission is that you are free to not engage the enemies you do not want to engage. So, yeah. Like, you don't necessarily need to engage every single enemy that you see. It's perfectly fine if you choose to spare a few enemies. Not that they'll do the same for you, but you can conserve ammunition. So, you don't even need to get to checkpoint Bravo. As soon as you get on top of this hill, you can pretty much find the objective right in front of you. Just get on top of this hill, that is one of the SAM sites, right over there. And over here would be one of the other SAM sites. Over here, right over here. And I think that is the enemy helicopter, which has been deployed. Where's the... there it is. Time to shoot it down. Yeah, I just love this gun because it's so powerful it can take anything out if you shoot it enough times. Including these missiles here. Now you can use laser designation just to show you guys how powerful it really is.
This is King 6 requesting fire mission, over.
King 6, Whiskey 1, send your fire mission, over.
Let me just go ahead and use it once, and you basically click and you hold the mouse on it like this. And what it's gonna do is, it's gonna drop a grenade from the sky, and that's it. That is all it is going to do. The grenade is significantly more powerful when it comes to damage, but not range. And it is not accurate at all. Like, you guys can see that I am aiming right at the missiles, but it still misses. So the better strategy here would be to just simply aim for the missiles instead. Destroying the missiles is a much more easier thing to achieve. These guys, do I really want to take them on now? Let them be. As far as this area over here is concerned, we just need to destroy these missiles as well. And instead of using the laser designator, I would like to keep sticking to the same principle of shoot the missiles instead. That there go the missiles, and there are the trucks that we need to destroy.
Charlie 2 is down!
And that should achieve the primary objective as well.
King 6 to all elements. Bravo has destroyed the target. Pull back to rendezvous.
And at this point, all that's left to do is to practically just clear the path. If you see any enemies in your way, just take them out. Because, yeah, that's all that's left to do. You just need to kill them. Because otherwise, yeah, they'll turn around and they'll kill you. So you don't want that happening. So the better option is to kill them first. Do not spare enemies in your path. And if new ones come into your path, kill them as well. Right now, we need to head in that direction. So I'm just gonna clear the neighboring areas out, and I'm going to check using the scope of the sniper if
Black Widow to Bravo, the LZ is hot. I repeat, the LZ is hot.
Roger, Black Widow. Now, there is somebody inside this bunker here. There was a bunker down here, wasn't there? Yeah, I think that's it. Yeah, so there's an enemy inside that bunker there. You don't really need to worry about them because, frankly, those guys suck. People inside the bunkers, I mean. And I think I see somebody running over there. Probably my bad. I don't see them anymore, really. There is a support base here. And taking them out is not compulsory at all. But it is going to help quite a bit with your exfiltration, I mean. People at the base of this hill here. That person over there, for example, who's running away, and his friend who's running behind him, following his lead. essentially. I cannot see any more enemies here, from here at least. And I mean, I can't hear them firing at me. That's probably just their fear taking over. Because I cannot see any more enemies here. I can see some enemies over on this side. And I think that guy is inside this. So I still can't see where the enemies are. Ah, there you are. Ah, good to know. So, yeah, this one guy over here, where did it go? He's probably inside this bunker somewhere. And yeah, I just can't see the bunker anymore. Where did the bunker go? Anyway, let us keep moving towards our extraction point. Be careful to preserve enough ammo so that you can actually reach the extraction point without harm. I would say that most of this area has been cleared. There are still some people left there near the extraction point. Let me just go on top of this hill first. Move from hill to hill. There should be another person inside the bunker over there. Let's just take him out for good measure as well. Because after all, these people can be pesky if not taken care of. And I think there are some people on top of this hill right here. I would take my handgun out just to be careful. And hopefully I don't get shot down by them, because I'm getting tired of trying this mission again and again. Yes, they are on top of the hill. Who's shooting at me? Is that... yeah, that... it is you. Two people here. Probably one there. Another one should be somewhere around here. And yeah, I'm getting hit with a lot of shots. I cannot see the enemy yet again. I suppose there he is. Well, that is just a tree, and that is the enemy right there. Time to shoot them down. Should be another one over here. I cannot see them. There he is. And yeah, that's pretty much the entire game. Just keep shooting as many enemies as you can until you are free to extract. That guy was sitting there. So we took out the objective. Right now all we have left to do is take out the enemies that are keeping us from extracting. And I would really appreciate it if I could save a few bullets instead of having to waste them all on these people. Now what I can do from this point on is go here in this direction, because from what I can tell from the map, there's little to no resistance in that area. Just that there's this one guy over here. I don't really know where he is, but yeah, there's this one guy over there that I would probably like to be too cautious of. Yeah, I don't know why it happened, but one of these times when I was playing, the helicopter just randomly managed to notice me, and yeah, it circled around to try and attack me. And it attacked me. At that point, I had two options. Now, who's shooting at me, I wonder? There are enemies here, as far as I can see. And yeah, I do not think this was the wisest course of action for me. Not at this point, anyway. Ah, there you are. You have a handgun, sir. You should not go up against a sniper rifle with a damn handgun. And first off, I will probably go ahead and link up with Alpha Team or Charlie Team, whichever that is, first before I attempt to cross over to the extraction point. I know I'm going farther from it, but I would just like to take the visor route and avoid enemy contact, because yeah, the odds are against us. The odds are against us right now, and we just need to make it to extraction in a visor manner instead of taking everybody on that we can. Just circumvent them entirely. Alpha is right there. We also need to save a few bullets to clear the extraction point. Because as far as I can tell, it is a hot extract. I'm just going to get near this person here. I don't know whether that is Charlie or Alpha. I think I heard a bullet whiz right past me. But who knows. Yeah, that was a bullet that was aimed at me. I don't know where it's coming from, but it is. Hi, Charlie. There are bullets being shot at me. Wait, are you shooting at some of them? That is so nice of you, Charlie One. With a submachine gun at that. Aww, so cute. Anyway, moving to extraction. Just be a little cautious while moving, because even though we are behind the enemy here, we are not behind enemy lines yet. And you can always face or find the aberrant astray enemy in this game. You never know. This game just looks so much better, without like this level at least, I suppose. This campaign looks so much better without the night vision thus far, even though I've only played one mission thus far. I can't possibly begin to compare it to the rest. But is that our helo, or is that the enemy helo that I heard last time around? The extraction point is only 365 meters away, but I can hear a helo. Now the thing is, I was following this path through the mountains the previous time around, when I actually saw the enemy helicopter suddenly spot me and started, and subsequently started assaulting. We know that is in fact our helicopter. We are safe. Let me just go ahead and take out any of opposition here, because it is apparently a hot extract. And what I do not understand is how, even though this is a hot extract, these guys are not targeting the helo. Because by all means they should be. They're just running circles around it. Only 8 more bullets left. Need to use them wisely. Oh, of course you wanna take cover behind the helicopter. Good thing that I did not hit the helo. At any rate, it is time that we extract. Heading over to extraction now. Charlie team, it's sad that Charlie even kept providing suppressing fire so that I could escape. The sacrifice shall not be in vain.
This is Black Widow. We're approaching the extraction point. We're coming in hot.
You're already here, Black Widow. You can get down on the ground now. Or maybe you don't want this like hot extract, right? I need to jump into the helicopter. Anyway, this was these missions are taking more of a strategic turn than they are the more action tactical sort of thing that they were before. Thus far on this mission I've got 30 kills. I think the total number of enemies on this map was 50. Congratulations on a job well done, Bravo team. The destruction of the enemy SAM sites has allowed our air units to attack with little to no risk. Allied ground units have been able to pick up the tempo of their operations now that they are not facing constant artillery bombardment. It appears that the enemy has begun to pull forces back towards the center of the island. Now that we know the location of the enemy's main command and control facility and remaining air base in the area, we can initiate hostilities to eliminate both. Initiate hostilities, I like how they put that. With both facilities being well behind enemy lines, Special Forces Command has been tasked with creating and implementing plans for the destruction of each of them. Thanks to the excellent work that you have already done, you will be given the opportunity to lead each of these assaults. Of course. That unlocks two more missions for us, Rapid Strike and Scorpion. And in this mission, these missions in this campaign at least seem to take a more strategic turn, because the enemies are very difficult. They shoot more accurately and their bullets do a lot of damage. You die instantly. Previously I've noticed that in the older campaigns, whenever a bullet hits you, it makes the screen red, sort of gives you like a warning shot that you have been hit, and then usually the next bullet is the one that kills you, unless it's a headshot. In this game, no matter where the bullets hit you in this campaign thus far, you are dead, and they hit you far more often, so you need to take it more strategically and methodically, and you can forget about outskilling the enemies because they are far superior skilled than you are. So yeah, it's more about repositioning, maneuvering, than it is about shooting, as far as I can tell. This campaign, far slower gameplay, but I suppose that is for a tactical shooter, strategic shooter rather, the kind of thing that Delta Force is, my impression of this game, should be. So at any rate, what I realized was that the laser designator sucks, and yeah, it's not worth it. It's not worth it at all. Rapid Strike and Scorpion, the two missions that we have unlocked. The next time we come back, we shall be addressing either one of these. I'll make a decision when I open the game back up. So, until then, thank you for watching Chain Lightning with me today, and I will see you guys next time. Take care. Farewell, fellow Earthlings.